Hi, my name is Shelby Vani. I'm here at the Darden School Investing Conference talking about technology with some industry luminaries. So let me introduce them. We have Scott Ferber, who's the CEO of Videology, Ned Hooper, who is a partner at CenterView, and Henry Ellenbogen, who runs the New Horizons Fund at T. Rowe Price. Pleasure to be with you guys.
Thanks for having us, Shelby.
So one of the topics we talked about this morning was this issue of kind of market valuation and whether we're in a bubble or not. We have Twitter, who just went public at a $23 billion valuation. We have Snapchat just having turned down a $3 billion valuation. We have Facebook over $100 billion valuation. Many of us lived through the late 90s bubble. Are we in another bubble again? Scott?
I don't believe we are in another bubble. The change that technology is having and the impact on a lot of these industries is such that the market values from the traditional companies are just being redistributed to the new ones. I'm in the media business, and if you look at and add up the market values 10 years ago of Time Warner and all the broadcasters and the newspapers and everyone else, all that value has just somewhat shifted to the Googles, the Facebooks, and the rest. So I don't see us in a bubble. I just see us in a transition of market value from the old to the new.
But when you take a company that's got no revenue, it's hard to argue the value has really shifted. Maybe market value shifted, but not real
consumer value. It's a great point. And it's more about the future belief of what we all think will happen and the fact that these new companies like Twitter are going to be dominant in the new media landscape. So there is a large valuation placed on that. And I think it'd be great to hear from our fellow comrades over here about how they view it, given that they invest in those companies.
Yeah.
So I don't think there's a broad-based bubble. I think that the factors that were there that we lived through in the internet bubble is very different. I do think that the market broadly is paying a big premium for growth right now. And there's a whole set of factors for that. I think the most significant is just the broad global GDP malaise that we're in. It's causing people to look hard at growth, and technology provides that growth opportunity. It's one of the few places in the market you can rely on to grow, the redistribution that Scott talked about. But I don't think there's a broad base, but I do think that there are going to be a lot of companies that are now currently priced to perfection that are going to see high volatility. So as any investor, you have to be very cognizant about the asset that you're in and how it performs as it normalizes into very high early valuations in the cycle.
Henry, you know this firsthand. I mean, you invested in Twitter 4 years ago at a much lower valuation. I mean, so you've seen the whole ride. How do you feel about this bubble question?
Yeah, I think when we look at the technology market, we see different markets. You know, above 25 billion, on balance, there's a handful of companies that trade above a market premium, and most of them trade at a market discount. Because basically, what the market is saying, both on the consumer tech side and on the enterprise technology side, is that we're going through a significant platform transition, and the market caps of those companies are basically being passed on to the new generation. Now, then when we look at the new generation of companies, what we would say is, the market is pricing many of these businesses as if they're win business models. That they will be the market leaders of the next generation, and that there's not some if or there's not some chance that they don't become it. And so when we look at the companies below 20 billion, and certainly the ones that are getting these very, very high private valuations, you know, $3-5 billion, what we would say is probably there's a little bit too much certainty that these companies are going to assume the cash flows of the old generation companies.
And when you guys look at kind of what you see in the technology market now, what are big trends that you think are kind of important to the investing community?
You know, I think the trends that we would point to right now is clearly on the consumer internet side, there's a big transition to mobile multiple devices, right? So if you go back, you know, just to the Facebook IPO, after that, the consumer internet market publicly really kind of took a stumble. Because what the market saw very publicly out of Facebook in some of those early IPOs of that cycle, you know, Zynga and Groupon, was that these companies were having tremendous challenge transitioning to the mobile environment. Now the market, I think, believes it's sorted out the winners and has put a very, very high premium on the mobile winners. And Twitter was born in the mobile age and has a very low discount rate on becoming a much bigger company. Concurrently, on the enterprise side, over the last couple of years, with companies like Workday and ServiceNow and Salesforce, the market basically believes that what used to be $1 trillion of market cap on the last generation winners is going to get redistributed to a handful of new generation winners, and some of those companies trade at very high multiples. And then the third trend we would say is kind of the blurring of the consumer and the enterprise. So we haven't seen a good example yet in the public markets, but in the private markets we would point to companies like Evernote and Dropbox, who basically are allowing consumers to bring their productivity suite that they really love at home, and they're forcing the CIOs to bring this into work. And so those are, you know, three major things that we're focused on.
But Ned, how do you think about big trends right now?
Yeah, so I absolutely agree relative to the trends in the enterprise, and we define that as saying there's a huge push towards technologies that can drive enterprise productivity and that can drive enterprise competitiveness versus just basic infrastructure build. The thing I would add to it is, you know, the overall pull at mobile that we tend to talk about as a commerce play and a consumer and enterprise application play is also driving significant innovation on the radio infrastructure side. Mm. And we're seeing a next generation of companies start to emerge that can use software to dynamically manage the utilization of spectrum. And spectrum is a highly constrained and highly valuable commodity. So I think there's some very interesting trends in actually managing on the network side, the spectrum utilization.
God, we're running out of time. A quick thought on trends.
Multi-device media consumption. In 1945, you could actually advertise to a third of the entire population with one ad on Dragnet. Today, you couldn't get maybe 15% at the most popular show. And it used to be that three generations would watch their content around one TV, and now you have one consumer with five devices in front of them. So what does that mean for content consumption? What does that mean for marketers? What does that mean for media companies? I think that's a big trend that's going to be taking off in the near future.
That's great. Well, it's been a pleasure to be with you guys, and thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.